Well, Merry Christmas, everybody! Here we are at one of the greatest moments of my interviewing career on the Stephen Holt Show. It's our Christmas program, and what could be more Christmassy than the new movie Mrs. Henderson Presents, and we're here. It's my great honor to be here with Dame Judi Dench. Welcome.
Thank you.
Dame Judi, Judi, just...
Judi.
Yes. Judi, yes. Another great role. I've been following your career since I was a student in England, and I saw your viola.
Right.
At Stratford. I was at a school near Stratford, and we got to see you.
You're going to tell me your little legs couldn't reach the ground?
No. Hardly. You were a great viola, unforgettable, and now another... Every role is a great role if you're playing it. And Mrs. Henderson, what a great part.
Yes, it's a good part.
Yes, very big.
Yes, good, spiky, you know, woman.
All the way through the whole film. You're in almost every scene, practically.
Yes.
Did they...
I think she interfered her way into it all.
Did you know her, the original? This is a true story.
No, it's absolutely true story. I just was aware of the windmill and Vivian Van Damme.
Uh-huh. Who is played by Bob Hoskins.
Bob Hoskins. And so I didn't know about Mrs. Henderson at all. And his neighbours, Bob's great friends, didn't know about her either until on a programme they were collecting, they found out Mrs. Henderson. And so they went down that road and found out about her.
Because she was quite a character.
Wasn't she?
She reminds me a lot of a friend of mine, Thelma Holt.
I knew Thelma Holt so well. It is Thelma Holt, actually.
I thought it was. I said, oh no, she's channeling Thelma here.
I should have been doing then is wear a lot of Issey Miyake, and then it would have been Thelma.
Right, because my last name is Holt, and we've become...
It's adorable.
Distant. We're not really related so far as we know, but what the hell, right? Yeah, she is Thelma Holt, because Thelma's very spicy.
Very, very good part for Thelma, actually.
Yes, well... You say all these things and do all these things in the movie that are sort of, I mean, you're a dame of the British Empire. I didn't think, you know.
That doesn't make any difference to anything, you know. Don't please think that has anything to do with respectability.
Well, I have interviewed Sir Ian, and I realized at that, Sir Ian McKellen, and I realized at that moment, indeed, you're right about that.
See what I mean?
Yes, because he's quite outrageous and fun and, you know, unpretentious like you are. Well, I mean, how did you, did they just give you the script, or did Stephen Frears tell you about
no,
it?
No, Bob Hoskins and Norma Heyman organized a lunch in London where I went, and they told me the story. Told me about her and gave a little kind of synopsis thing, and I was hooked immediately. I wanted to work with Bob too, who I'd known, and we'd done King Lear together with John Gielgud on the radio, but not ever on stage. And he was Billy Connolly's first choice for Queen Victoria, Bob Hoskins, in Mrs. Brown. So I've wanted to work with him for a long, long time. And so immediately, I mean, before the main course, I was hooked and wanted to do it. Well, and who wouldn't be? And then the next day, Stephen Frears was on board and Martin Sherman's script arrived. And then I was in All's Well That Ends Well in the theatre at the time. And I just rang Stephen and said, why can't we start this in the morning? Because it was, you know, it's one of those jobs that you ran to do.
Right. Were they in production already when they came to you, or rehearse it, or?
No. This was going to be done, and I got to read what it was going to be.
So there was like no rehearsal beforehand. You just showed up and you shot the scene.
Yes, and well, Stephen, you know, he sometimes rehearses and kicks the scene about a bit and says directs by stealth.
He directs Stephen. By stealth.
Yes.
Oh, that's interesting. Does he take people aside and whisper
Oh, no, you can't detect the stealth. It just happens.
It just happens.
I don't know what I'm doing here, but he does now.
Because it's also so rare that you're here in America, you know,
nice
doing
for me.
This.
Lovely for me.
Yes, well, you were here the last time you were here, you won a Tony for your play on Broadway.
Yes.
And I think the last time you were here before that, you won an Oscar for Shakespeare. You just come over, we give you everything. Well, I often wonder what it's like when people, you know, look up to you like you're sort of the Olivier figure, you know, they're sort of the role model for
they
actors.
They don't do that.
They don't do that?
No.
Oh, well.
Not my friends don't.
Your friends don't. Well, probably the young people in school, you know, students.
Well, I don't.
What do you say to students when they come? Do you ever speak to them, ask them what, if they ask your advice about the theater?
Q&A things, yes, but I'm not good. I'm often asked to do a master class, but I wouldn't know how to begin. I couldn't do that. That's something I, you know, couldn't do. I can say to somebody if they do a speech for me or an audition speech, then I could advise them about some aspect of it, and I could help them that way. But people are writing saying, can I have money? Because, you know, they're not, you know, they have no subsidy and they can't get to drama school.
Oh, well.
So that letter arrives about 8 times a week, I suppose.
Oh, goodness gracious, I never thought of that, yes. But it is such a complex thing, knowing what to say to someone about their career. If you can be specific about one person and one thing,
I think also that you, if somebody has an idea about anything else, anything else at all, if they've considered anything else, then in a way, don't do it. Because
right.
it's upsetting.
It's
full of knocks, and it's
but this is the most
sustain.
Wonderful moment of my entire television career so far. What
I shall tell Thelma.
Please do, and because otherwise you'll have to just go out and see Mrs. Henderson Presents, because Dame Judy has to run on to the next interview now. So, I mean, thank you so much for being here today on the Stephen Holt Show.
Pleasure.